The universe will be around long after we are all gone, and that means we are going to miss some really important events. I've spoken on the channel previously about events that will happen in the near future. Things like asteroids hitting Earth and Saturn losing its iconic rings. But this time, I want to dive deeper and go further than we ever have before. I'm going to take you trillions and trillions of years into the future and show you some insane events that will happen in the universe when you and I are long gone. Let's start in the near future. Cosmically speaking, scientists have hypothesized that Jupiter's famous Great Red Spot will disappear over the next few hundred years, and possibly even within a few decades. The Great Red Spot is essentially just a massive storm in Jupiter's atmosphere. It's been raging for at least the last 200 years, and possibly even longer. And I really do mean massive. It is 1.3 times wider than the Earth, and it produces winds traveling at nearly 1,000 kilometers per hour. But it used to be much, much bigger. Back in the 1800s, it was about 4 times larger than it is today, and it continues to shrink every single year. While storms on Earth only last a few weeks, this storm has been raging for hundreds of years, and someday, probably once we're gone, the storm will finally disappear. Jumping forward to the year 50,000, Earth will begin a transition to a terrifying period of time. We are currently in an interglacial period, essentially just the time between ice ages, and when it ends, things are going to get really cold. Over the following tens of thousands of years, global temperatures would plummet and large portions of the northern hemisphere would be completely covered in massive glaciers. Ice sheets around the world would expand and grow, covering much of North America, Europe, and Asia. These expanding glaciers will contain a lot of our water, causing sea levels to drop by up to 100 meters. Ecosystem populations would migrate to the warmer climates near the equator, while deserts grow, tropical environments shrink. This would, of course, have a huge impact on the human population, as agriculture would become increasingly difficult and access to fresh water would become a global issue. This is bound to happen sometime in the future. Or maybe not. Scientists have suggested that climate change driven by humanity could end up delaying this ice age or even preventing it altogether, effectively skipping the next ice age. By then, maybe technology would have been developed to help mitigate the impact of this natural cycle. But personally, I'm glad that we're going to miss out on this one. Looking to the extremely distant future, 50 to 100 million years from now, Antarctica will once again turn green into a tropical oasis. Yeah, you heard that correctly. Once again. No one seems to talk about the fact that Antarctica used to be a green tropical oasis with a climate similar to what we see in modern day Italy. Seriously. Antarctica used to just be like any other continent until over millions of years it began slowly drifting south. This migration period lasted for nearly 100 million years and just happened to coincide with a period in time where carbon dioxide levels fell globally, leading the planet to cool down. And then 34 million years ago, it stopped wandering. This caused an ice sheet to form over the continent, giving us the Antarctica we know and love today. So why do I say it might turn green once more? Well, this can only happen if the ice cover melts, revealing the soil and land beneath. For this to happen, we would essentially just need to turn back the clocks. If climate change resulted in significantly higher CO2 levels in the future, the ice sheet will certainly begin melting and the continent will likely begin wandering back further north. But the sheet of ice over Antarctica is really thick, like almost 5 kilometers thick in some places. If the entire sheet melted, the global sea levels would rise by over 60 meters, causing massive amounts of destruction. If this does happen in 50 to 100 million years, we might actually end up with a brand new lush continent here in the southern hemisphere. Even if Antarctica doesn't just wander away and become tropical again, we might not need to wait for a new tropical continent to be born. 250 million years from now, all of the continents on Earth will crash together, mountain ranges will be created, and a new supercontinent will arise, Pangaea Ultima. The worst part is, some studies have suggested that humans will have little chance of surviving on this new supercontinent, as it will be fatally hot. This is a cyclic process. Every 400 to 600 million years, the continents of Earth crash back together again, like some massive Newton's cradle. Australia would be neighbors with China. The Americas would be right beside Africa, and Africa would be smashed into Europe and Asia. This intense process would create all kinds of new mountain ranges, potentially even larger than the Himalayas and Mount Everest. The scary part is, this new continent would become superheated by all of this CO2 that's being erupted from volcanoes and thermals as a result of the collision. Average temperatures across the continent would soar to 40 or even 50 degrees Celsius. This combined with high levels of humidity would make it hard for any mammals to survive. While it would be pretty fun to be able to drive from New York to London to Sydney, I think I'll take the cooler climate. Over the next 1 billion years, our sun is going to change, causing the end of all life here on Earth. As our sun ages, it continues to get brighter and brighter every year. This brightness increases around 10% every billion years. While that doesn't sound like a whole lot, it actually will have significant consequences for the delicate balance of life here on Earth. This increased luminosity will result in a runaway greenhouse effect. Temperatures will soar, photosynthesis will cease, and the Earth's oceans will be evaporated away. This is actually what happened to Venus billions of years ago, and it will mark the end of all life here on Earth. All the plants will be bathed in harmful UV radiation, causing them to die off, and with them, the entire food chain will collapse. Oxygen production will end. Our atmosphere will become toxic. Any animals, including us humans, will have to either leave or perish. Eventually, Earth will lose all of its surface water to space, leaving behind a dry, barren rock, constantly being cooked by an ever-brightening sun. This starts the clock. We have 3 billion years. To leave Earth or humanity will perish. And I think we'll do it. We have already detected over 5,000 exoplanets. I've covered them on this channel many times before, so definitely go check those videos out. But over the next 3 billion years, I'm pretty confident that humanity will step foot on and begin colonizing Earth 2.0. This will be a huge milestone in humanity's history. We would no longer be constrained to a single star, a multi-stellar community of humans free to explore. Don't get me wrong, it will be really hard and take unimaginable amounts of time, resources, and effort, but given 3 billion years and the fact that we will have to leave the Earth someday to survive, I'm confident we can do it. And the opportunities for where we can go are truly endless. Planets with rings 100 times larger than Saturn's, planets where all plant life is red, super habitable planets where humanity could flourish for billions and billions of years. The list goes on. We are only going to continue to find more and more amazing exoplanets with the launch of new telescopes. The James Webb Space Telescope has already begun searching for signs of life on alien worlds. But there is just too much interesting science to be covered in this video, which is why I've partnered with Magellan TV. They have an awesome documentary piece called Planet Hunting with the James Webb Space Telescope, which explains exactly how astronomers are using JWST to hunt for Earth 2.0. If you enjoy my videos, then I'm sure you'll love this documentary, as well as the hundreds of other amazing pieces they have ready to stream now. And what makes it even better is Magellan TV is completely ad-free. It's just an affordable way to consume high-quality tech and science content. All you need to do is click the link at the top of the description to sign up today and watch Planets Hunting with the James Webb Space Telescope. Viewers of the channel will get a 7-day free trial, as well as some amazing discounts on gift cards for the holiday season. Now, let's head a trillion years into the future. This is the cosmic microwave background, a snapshot of the first light emitted in the universe right after the Big Bang. It is one of the most significant observations ever made by humans, and in around 100 billion years from now, it will effectively disappear from our view forever. This is because the universe itself is expanding. Here's how it works. As the space itself stretches out, the photons from the CMB are also being stretched. This is known as Doppler shift. Currently, we see the CMB as a glow of microwaves, but as time goes on, it will continue to shift further and further down the electromagnetic spectrum into radio waves. Over 100 billion years, these wavelengths will just be so stretched out, decreasing their energy to the point where we would need a telescope the size and power of an entire solar system to detect it. So one day, our faint picture of the Big Bang will disappear from the view of any onlookers, locking that information away forever. Now, we are jumping so far into the future that time essentially becomes meaningless. 100 trillion years from now, the universe will transition into a new and haunting era. Stars will die and run out of fuel, plunging the cosmos into darkness. Stars are kind of like the furnaces of the universe, forging new heavy elements, igniting galaxies and planets. But every star only has so much fuel. One day, star formation will cease entirely, the last stars being born of the leftover gas and dust. The bigger the star, the quicker they will die. Smaller red dwarf stars will slowly begin to fade. They are so efficient that they can last up to 10 trillion years, but eventually they will still lose out to time. With no stars left shining, the universe will be a cold and lonely place, populated by the corpses of the leftover stars, black holes, neutron stars, and even black dwarfs. After 1 quadrillion years, the first black dwarfs in the universe will form. These strange objects are so rare that scientists are confident not even one exists in the universe today. Black dwarfs are the ultimate end state of stars like our sun. When white dwarfs cool down over trillions of years, they lose all of their remaining energy and no longer radiate light or heat. By the time these objects first start emerging, the universe will have expanded so much and grown so cold that the average temperature of the entire universe will approach absolute zero. That's the coldest anything can ever get. And this marks the beginning of the end of the universe. But there is one kind of cosmic object that is yet to form: zombie galaxies. These are galaxies comprised entirely of black holes. After enough time, the black holes in the universe will consume the remaining black dwarfs and neutron stars. Black holes are the only objects left wandering the cosmos in complete darkness. Despite there being no more light to illuminate them, gravity will take over, creating zombie galaxies. A central supermassive black hole surrounded by hundreds of millions, even billions of smaller black holes orbiting it. These galaxies will not look like the vibrant galaxies we see today. They will be a lonely reminder of what once was a universe filled with beauty and life. And then the universe will ultimately come to an end. Black holes will evaporate away via Hawking radiation, protons will decay, and the universe will go cold and quiet for eternity. Or will it? The end of the universe is a huge topic, and there are a few different ways astronomers believe the universe might end, so I think it deserves its own video. So subscribe so you don't miss it.